Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Mr. Riaz Chamdia, President, Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan. Ms. Huna Usmani, Chartered Accountants Women's Committee. Ms. Khurshid Kotwal, Team Leader, Organizing Committee. Mr. Ilango, Country Director, World Bank. Professor Taur Rahman. Valued guests, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum. I am indeed delighted to be invited by the Chartered Accountants of Women's Committee of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan to speak at the Leadership Summit on Scaling the Fourth Industrial Revolution. I am very pleased to see that ICAP is taking such concrete and commendable steps for gender diversification in the chartered accountant profession. ICAP is a pioneer in the field of professional education in Pakistan. ICAP members have made a mark for themselves all over the world and can proudly boast of their achievements. The government of Sindh is also a strong advocate of supporting women in every field because they have a pivotal role in the progress and development of Pakistan. The government of Sindh Department for Women Development has devised an active provincial policy for women development and also supports women in the field of business. The government of Sindh is also working to achieve commitments agreed upon with international organizations such as the International Labour Convention, the Beijing Declaration, and the Convention for Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women to remove all obstacles women face when they want to move forward in their careers, education, as well as other goals. The theme of the conference of the summit today is very appropriate. As we can all see that the fourth industrial revolution is already making a great impact all over the world. Just yesterday I was sitting down with a friend and we were recalling, we started talking about cricket. We started hearing cricket commentary on our radio sets. You know, we are of that generation when there were no televisions. Only some houses used to have a television set, and in order to watch cricket live, we would go to a friend's house who had a television to watch cricket. And then later in the 70s, the colored television sets came in, and we had this cricket in color. And that was something, watching Wimbledon and cricket test matches for 5 days together in front of a television set, that was technology, that was the ultimate. And if you talk to kids about this now, just this morning I was having my breakfast and on the television there was a program coming, and I don't remember the exact numbers, but I think in the young Fortune 500, there's 6 Pakistanis. And one of them was being interviewed. He was from Northern California, from the Bay Area. And he had a company in artificial intelligence. And he was talking about his company. So this is where we have come from in the last, you know, 5 decades, starting with radio sets. And now you can watch, you know, talking about cricket, so you can watch cricket anywhere on your cell phone, you know, we're just talking to the president, and he said the largest taxi company in the world does not own a taxi. That is technology. That is the fourth industrial revolution that we're talking about. And countries who've not kept up with the advancement and technology have been left behind. And although we've got great brains all around the world, but we've not been able to capitalize, and I think that we need to rethink our priorities and make sure that the human capital that we have, Ilango talked about the 207 million plus, and you know, we need to control population, but the population that we have, the human resource that we have, we need to make use of them. China has done it. China has become a great power, and one of the reasons is its population, though they've controlled population, but they used the human resource that they had, and China now has the, I believe, the biggest technology company in the world because of the huge market that they have. We have, talking about markets, a few days ago I was told that the internet users in Pakistan are more than the total population of Canada. And despite that, we've not been able to really capitalize on the technology revolution that has come in. So forums like this, I'm sure, will go a long way in promoting the technology advancement. And I'm sure that what comes out of this conference today would help the entrepreneurs, would help the people, because as Ilang was saying, business has changed altogether. With the advancement in technology, the way that you think, the way that you operate is entirely changed. And we need to keep up with this. The government of Sindh, I'll just talk briefly in terms of what we're doing. We've got an information science and technology department. We're working on recruitment based, and we've already got that software. We've developed that software to provide all kinds of jobs through a web-based portal. In terms of using technology, in the last few years, we've developed a web portal whereby our entire finances, at one time, I remember, I've been a finance minister for 7 years now, and at that time, the release of money and the expenditure used to be a state secret, and we'd not divulge it. I don't know why. But now we have a system whereby on a bi-monthly basis, on a fortnightly basis, we give all the details on the finance department portal. And similarly, other departments have also been working on it. As the chief minister, I've tried to use technology. My entire secretariat, my schedules, the different projects that I'm personally monitoring, the constituency-wise projects that are being developed, I have them available on my iPad, and I try and follow them. So we have been using technology, but there's lots more we can do. And one of the reasons that we've not been able to develop that fast is because we've not been able to keep up with the advancement in this technology. Our land revenue system, our land records, despite what a number of people say, we've got in Pakistan the best land record systems. And I want to invite some of you someday to come to the revenue office, where they have where you can just put in your name and you'd get details of the land holdings that you have in the province. We've developed an e-policing system in Sindh. We've got in the secretariat a biometrics identification electronic card system. Right now, we're building capacity for training 15,000 Sindh government employees in the IT sector. And several other e-government projects are being undertaken. So the government of Sindh is working on catching up and being abreast with the developments in technology. And I would also request that any advice, any suggestions, any help that I can get from professionals would be most welcome. And in order to serve the people better, in order to ensure that we can provide, we can have good service delivery for the people of this province. I would like to congratulate the organizers for holding this event. I wish that you have a very successful event, and the outcomes are useful not only for the industry but also for the government. And I would love to get a copy of the proceeding so that we can follow up on this. Once again, I thank the organizers for having me here. It's a pleasure. Thank you very much.